What is something unrealistic that you often see in movies that annoys the hell out of you? Unrealistic wealth. Typical family with one working parent has a 4-bedroom house with an in-ground pool. College graduates living in some swanky penthouse on a babysitter salary. 24-year-old doctors. Overall lack of communication. I feel like 90% of all drama is coming from this in some way. Character could have prevented the whole situation if they explained one thing, but nope. When the mum prepares a feast for breakfast and everyone only takes a bite or two before rushing off, my mum would have killed me for wasting food. Also, she wouldn't prepare a feast for breakfast, milk and OJ in fancy jugs rather than the carton. The disregard for basic physics. The Fast and the Furious has entered the chat. High school scenes where there are lounges in the hallway and students are free to be wherever they want to be around the building. S. No matter the time of day without consequence. We had literally 4 minutes between classes to get into our lockers and across the building. Nobody was sitting down and during that. Omniscient bad guys. I know you have to have the plot move forward, but dude is trying to hide in Europe and somehow the villain is always where the hero wants to go before they get there. I mean, Europe is pretty damn big, and I can't imagine getting totally lost there would be all that difficult. And then they suddenly stop being omniscient at the end of the movie, letting the protagonist save the day. People living in these gigantic NY or LA apartments while working jobs that realistically could never pay for such a nice place. And if they do have a job that could afford those places, that they would have any time to get involved in whatever is happening in the plot. Reminds me of the bit in Friends where they're all in Central Perk. Someone asks why do all our bosses hate us and someone says maybe it's because you're drinking coffee with your friends at 2 PM on a Wednesday and they all get up and leave. When the entire plot rests on a character not explaining something that can be explained in under 1 minute. Characters making the dumbest, most unrealistic choices just to further the plot. Unnecessary sex scenes that add nothing whatsoever to the movie. Ordering at a restaurant and only taking one bite and leaving. In a post-apocalyptic world, somehow all cars on the road are parked or stranded in such a way that our main character has no problem driving between them. Witness protection somehow always fails in movies. Zombieland. For all its hokey shenanigans, got a nod of approval from me when it showed clogged up roads in Tallahassee driving a vehicle equipped with cattle catcher snowplow blade on the front for bashing derelict cars out of the way. Food for thought. After he did that, the cars would have stayed pushed to the side. Anyone that drives through the area later would be driving through an area like op originally described, with everything conveniently positioned. Maybe the convenient positioning of abandoned vehicles is actually realistic. Surely someone would push them aside. Likely the military if no one else. At least in major areas. Nobody opens the door 2 seconds after the doorbell rings. Nobody. Yeah, we're all inspecting who could possibly be at the house. At least 1 minute. Putting a bra on public appropriate clothes. Could be another minute. And then hyping ourselves up to open the door and hope it's not a murderer. 30 second minimum. People doing CPR. Then the person who just got CPR wakes up like 10 minutes later and eats lunch. Also, movies are really bad at maintaining sterile fields in operating rooms. Defibrillators are the worst in film. Never ever ever used for what they actually perform. They are not meant to start a stopped heart, they are there to try and reset a heart going into fibrillation arrhythmia. You mean they aren't portable Frankenstein labs? Clear. It's alive. I also like to watch for people who are not clear. The CPR wouldn't work anyway. They never do it right. In fairness, they did it right on a live actor. They'd bred ribs at best. Insurance rates would skyrocket. I love that pediatric patients have a heart rate of like 55 on monitors. 2. Calling someone, and then instantly start talking. I don't know why exactly, but that has really bothered me. You didn't even let it ring. Also, when they don't say bye when they hang up, my mom never identifies herself. Never makes sure she has the right person on the other end. Just starts talking. My boss never says hi when he calls me. This is how every phone call starts off. You there? I got something else for you. Gun silencers being that quiet. In reality, they're like the sound of someone clapping. For that matter, just about any gun being fired inside. The noise is deafening. Even in the movies you see people wearing hearing protection at a range. But then when action scenes occur, that aspect is completely thrown out. Action heroes apparently aren't scared of tinnitus. the old you cough, you die. My wife and I call that the two-scene warning ever since we saw A Walk to Remember many years ago. If you aren't the sole lead and openly acknowledge your illness, the clock is ticking. If you cough blood and weren't in a fight, same. To be fair, coughing blood is always bad sign. Someone shooting 10,683 rounds from a 1911 without reloading. The semi-auto muskets from Pirates of the Caribbean take the cake for that though. Casually strolling away from a massive explosion. They have eardrums of steel and shrapnel proof skin. It's legit. I googled it. You really need to watch The Other Guys then. The Other Guys 1080p explosion scene. Opaque beverage cups and are always empty and never look right when hefted and drank from. They could at least put water in them to get the motion right, but never do. And once you start noticing this, it just ruins so many shots for you because it looks so stupid. This is my biggest pet peeve. Exactly. Put some water in the cup. People shooting guns, especially pistols, from well over a reasonable range and hitting very small targets with one hand while running or something. People would be surprised how difficult it is to hit a target with a pistol from 15-20 yards standing still with two hands. How bad the villains always are at shooting. Don't get me wrong, Star Wars wouldn't be the same if Luke gets scalped by a stormtrooper 30 minutes into the first movie, but good god are they bad. Stormtroopers are overly emotional. They miss everyone. In the first Star Wars movie, Episode 4. It actually makes sense as it's established that the Empire allowed Luke and his friends to escape the Death Star so they could track them to the location of the Rebel base. In all subsequent movies, it makes no sense at all. Sometimes in sex scenes, the guy will just undo his belt and immediately stick his piece right in. No foreplay, no lube, just immediately right in within seconds. My wife and I call it Mad Men style sex because almost every sex scene in Mad Men was like this. I know it does happen, but Hollywood thinks all sex is immediately penetrative, and the woman is coming immediately. Probably because no Hollywood producer has ever made a woman climax before. Most of them have barely made a movie climax. No body hair, ever. This, and full makeup and hair always. Apocalypse, makeup and hair still done. Waking up after a full night of sleep, makeup and hair still done. Finishing up the workout, makeup and hair still done. When they are fine shaved but you can see that their legs are already shaved. This is more of an ad thing though. Stalkerish behavior being portrayed as romantic. The man in a relationship being portrayed as an ear-brained doofus. People getting knocked out cold for an hour, then waking up and going about their day like nothing's happened. I once got knocked out for like 2 minutes and ended up sick for a month. Yeah, they use a knockout like a human pause button. So many goons would have very serious brain damage. Shows like Lost make blunt force trauma to the brainstem look like such a non-issue, that if I lived in that world I might ask a friend to hit me in the back of the head if I was having a particularly difficult time sleeping one night. I was knocked out for 5 minutes and spent 3 weeks in an induced coma, and have permanent brain damage from it, though thankfully mild enough to be inconvenient rather than debilitating. Head injuries are not to be trifled with. If someone is unconscious for an hour with no treatment, there's a good chance they aren't waking up. I read somewhere once that if a person gets knocked out and doesn't wake up inside of about 30 seconds, they're going to have, at best, significant brain trauma issues. Ever since then I catch myself counting the seconds when I see someone get knocked out in a movie to try and figure out how messed up they're going to be. I've had light speech problems for 2 years after said 2 minutes. Someone gets hit so hard that they fly through a wall. Then they get up and keep fighting. No, you're going to spend the next year learning to walk again. Yeah, especially the ninja moves. Everything is always so dark, and no one ever bothers to turn the lights on. Even when they do, it's like a 10W bulb in a warehouse that only illuminates 2 feet around it. I always see the opposite, where someone turns out the lights to go to sleep but it's still somehow bright enough in the room to see every detail. There is no easy way to film darkness. Everyone always answers their phone, usually on the first ring, and no matter where you are, you have perfect reception, except in horror movies. Pretty much any police detective show, female detective constantly wearing high heels, which would be uncomfortable alone and very challenging during the inevitable foot chase scene. Immediately upon discovering evidence at a crime scene, they will pick it up using a loosely held glove or the tip of a pencil. In real life, evidence needs to be documented, photographed before handled, and how lazy are you that you can't properly slip on a glove? Just about everything else forensics wise. Everyone with loose hair, rarely wearing gloves, every fingerprint or other piece of evidence is relevant to the crime. The crime scene line is like 10 feet from the body, so the public has a great view of everything, and of course any nearby evidence is destroyed. Every time the cop says that you have to tell me X or I am going to arrest you for obstruction. Hot Fuzz did pretty good with his ex being unidentifiable at a crime scene, cause everyone is covered head to toe with PPE. My son-in-law is a video game programmer, and it drives him crazy when in cop shows movies they use a computer to search for a match to fingerprints or a face, and the screen scrolls with the images flashing on the screen. He's like, do you know how much computing power it takes to render all those images? The computer doesn't need to flash them on the screen. And all the goddamned beeping. I hate how noisy every computer application is in TV movies. I'm only a web developer, and it blows my mind when hackers and programmers speed through a project. Like, F man, it took me 3 months to make a web page and you just created an advanced AI in a half hour. Hacker casually hacks Pentagon in 10 minutes. Mostly in rom-coms. People randomly running into each other out in public. Like, how small is your town that you bumped into the same person 3 days in a row at a restaurant bar shop? Yet all rom-coms take place in Nick. Well, plenty of them are about the overworked woman who has to leave Nick for a small town for whatever reason at the beginning. Visiting her hometown. Reporting for a story. Stranded on the way to something. Doing some real estate deal. And both falls in love with the charming local man. Maybe her high school crush or just her charming bachelor who's been hurt before. But also he stands in the way of her real estate deal. And learns how much better life is in small towns where people care about each other. Also maybe she learns the meaning of Christmas. Computer work is only done via vigorous typing on the keyboard. Never a single mouse click. When two characters do something simple like glancing at each other and then the romance has started. If a man and a woman bump into each other and some music plays, that's enough to ensure the romance has begun. I bump into guys all the time. Where's my boyfriend? I think I know where you went wrong. Oftentimes the person has to be in a hurry, carrying many things. Bonus points if there's at least one tray full of coffee. Already frustrated. And when you bump into the guy, you have to sound initially angry, but once you look into his, more often than not, dazzling blue eyes, stop mid-sentence. Then the music plays and boyfriend is acquired. Common mistake. Lmao during COVID, bumping into someone immediately sends them in the other direction. But I'll be sure to bring my phone to play soft music while after. I agree the trope is played out. But it can happen. No bullsh. My wife and I met at the parts store I worked at, and we both couldn't stop thinking about each other after a 2-minute interaction. It took us 9 months to find each other again. We didn't know each other's names, and every time she swung by to find me I was not working. Found out who I was by seeing me in an old photo with her cousin back in high school and called her cousin to get my info. Friended me on social media and we started dating. Been together 9 years. It does happen. But it's certainly not the average experience. It was rather comical how it happened with the wife and I though. Coming this spring to the Hallmark Channel. Pull Apart My Heart, Recycled Love. I am 76 years old and have been buying things in stores since I was 5. I have never ever seen someone toss some money on a counter and say keep the change and then dash out with the purchase. I work in a liquor store. Customers do this once a week or so. Half the time I chase them outside, because it's not enough money to cover their purchase. They know what they're doing. Sprinklers going off indoors. When this happens in the movies, people are super excited, laughing, jumping around and playing in the water like it is raining. In reality, the water in those pipes is absolutely disgusting. Dirty, smelly, black water that would make most people run like hell to get away from. Source: I used to install sprinklers in buildings during my high school summers as a part-time job. When the plot completely ignores the events that just happened to take a wild twist. Everybody acting like the heroine is plain. She's wearing glasses and a baggy sweater and a ponytail. But her face is perfect. Her teeth are perfect. Her skin is perfect and she hasn't got an ounce of fat anywhere. But she has paint on her overalls. She's got glasses. and a ponytail. Also, the glasses are almost always glassless. Everyone looks cute in black frames till you stick some +4.50/1.75 lenses in them. Janie's got a gun. I hate when someone is driving and they're talking to the passenger without looking at the road for like 10 seconds at a time. Most fight scenes. Bar fight. Guy gets hit with 6 broken chairs. Several bottles broken over his head. Still gets up fine and fights off like 20 other guys. Real fighting is the most physically exhausting thing you can do. Your average person would barely last a minute. Most street fights are one of 2 punches before they get winded. Athletes have to do insane amount of endurance training and conditioning to be able to fight. 3 minutes in the ring will feel like a lifetime. Beyond that, too many such injuries will completely knock you out or be fatal. Again, on the street, if you punch someone, knock them out, and their head hits pavement, there is a fair chance you just kill them. Even then, most head injuries you just don't get up and keep fighting from. But because of Hollywood, every jackass thinks they can take on 20 guys at once or would do awesome in a fight. Exactly. I'm a black belt, and I remember starting training for my first full contact tournament. Hit the bag for 3 minutes, they said. 20 seconds later, is that 3 minutes? I can't breathe. I'm going to throw up, maybe pass out too. The way gifts are wrapped, they are always in boxes with actual lids, like shoe boxes, not ones with flaps. And the lid is wrapped separately from the box, so when they open the present, they just lift the lid. Also, if there's a ribbon wrapped around it, the ribbon's not taped on and slides right off. Has anyone ever done this in real life? Tried it once. It looked great, but it was a pain in the a to do, and it took forever. It's less work than having to wrap the presents normally and do the scene 87 times with a rewrap every time. Would give new meaning too. It's a wrap. Would be a giant pain in the a to rewrap each present in exactly the same way for multiple takes though. Organizing a date without mentioning time, place, day, etc. It's just an I'll pick you up tonight. High schoolers who look like effing supermodels, or even people in their 30s playing high schoolers. I watched 13 Reasons Why on Netflix and I immediately thought the guy who plays Tony was like 31. High schools that are college campuses. I was talking with a friend about high school and she was amazed that my school was all one building. Turns out in SoCal a lot of high schools have several or a dozen buildings. And you walk outside between classes or to eat lunch. Makes sense when it never rains or gets cold. I always thought that was fake Hollywood world building, but it turns out shows set scenes like that because they're common out there. Killing of nameless characters like it's nothing. Then pretending like the protagonist is a hero and a good person. Also sacrificing hundreds of nameless characters just to save a love interest. Hanging up the phone without saying anything at the end of a conversation. Imma say it. Just casually rolling over after having sex. Like no cleanup, no awkward run to the toilet. Who are these people? People with urinary tract infections. That's who. Also people that like to sleep in gross crusty sheets. No. No. She awkwardly walks to the toilet, but takes the entire bed sheet with her to cover herself up. Because God forbid the man she just had sex with looks at her nude so long as he isn't on top of her. Came here to say the same thing. Where are their sex towels? Where is the awkward condom pull off and disposal? What about sex puddles? No one goes to pee afterward. Is everyone a sex robot? People need to know. Post-sex piss waddling is a thing. How they fantasize relationships between men and women. No one acts like that. And it can put unreasonable expectations in the head of teenagers and young adults who are just starting to date. Yay. Grand gestures are great and all if you want to attract the attention of the, more often than not, girl of your dreams. But it could easily come off as creepy and stalkerish if the girl isn't a grand gestures type of person. They also make it seem like knowing basic facts about the person gives you points or something and you must love them back. And if you say no, then you're the bad guy. Because look how plucky and nice and kind the protagonist is. If only you give them a chance. I say this as a former dumb teenaged guy who took those movies too seriously. I always enjoy watching lab scenes. People looking into microscopes that aren't even turned on or plugged in. No one has gloves on or their hair pulled back. Unrelated formulas scrolled on whiteboards. And always, I mean all effing ways. If they are in a lab, be it a biology lab, physics, what have you, there will be chemistry glassware too. I mean, I did my PhD in physics and all the labs I ever worked in had glassware everywhere. If you really want to make a lab look realistic though, throw in random equipment from 3 or 4 decades ago. My first advisor had a PDP-11 shoved into the back corner and another computer in active use running Windows 3.1. Haha. Yes, labs always turn into little museums because either someone can't bear to part with their first piece of hardware or there's insane bureaucracy to get the go-ahead and start throwing stuff in the trash. Old anecdote from someone in a research lab. On the day that some of the funders were touring the facility, they pulled the test tubes out of the closet and filled them with colored water, and held them up to the light when the guests walked by. After they were gone, they put away the test tubes and went back to their computers. As a guy who works with computers, pretty much any computer scene, especially hacking scenes, if I bypass the firewall using a RESQL protocol, I can load the XML into the CSS stack and update the database to cross the JavaScript and SVG streams. And I'm in. Much of that is legitimate terminology, but used in a very wrong manner. I like to think that the original script had perfect instructions on how to hack into anything but was changed by the National Hackers Breakfast Club because they hacked in and put a bunch of nonsense to protect their secrets. Probably by using an if statement to inherit from a methods function. Women in historical drama wearing corsets directly against their skins. Back then clothes were expensive so people had to wear an additional layers of chemise or chiffon made from linen that can be frequently washed. It annoys me to no end when sexy scenes show sir dudes just pulling couple strings then historical ladies be butt naked in the matter of seconds while in reality you'd be needing an appointment and 3-5 business days before shorty finishes disrobing. Misunderstandings with dire consequences that could easily be cleared up if the protagonist just said something, anything. I don't have time to explain. They then take a 10-minute walk down a corridor together in silence. Inigo Montoya did it best. Let me explain. No. There is too much. Let me sum up. Proceeds to do so perfectly. I don't even have time to explain why I don't have time to explain. Woman. You are a literal time-traveling robot space magician. You have time to explain because you can jump to any other point in time whenever you please. That's the epitome of having surplus time. Childbirth. Water breaks. You go immediately to the hospital. It's time to push. She pushes 3 times and immediately reverts to her pre-pregnancy state. Also, her hair and makeup are immaculate. A bonus in unbelievability for surprise twins. A sudden marriage proposal. Or a newborn who is clearly 6 months or older. Horses neighing all the time. Neighing when they're running. Neighing when they're eating. Horses don't neigh that much. No matter the location or how crowded it is, there's always a parking space right exactly where someone's going to. Whenever they turn the TV on, it's not a commercial, not a soap opera on daytime television. No, it's always the news clip of the exact thing that pertains to what they were talking about 5 seconds earlier. Women having unfathomable orgasms after 0.3 seconds of penetrative sex. One neck kissing and she's already moaning. The whole blood ritual pact where they slice their palms. I've talked about this before. Because it pisses me off how so many movies and TV shows have this trope. It originated because it was an easy place for them to hide a blood packet back when special effects weren't what they are today. But I don't think Hollywood will evolve from that. It's so dumb though because if you've ever had a cut on the palm of your hand, you would know that's a terrible place to make a wound. It's such an awkward injury and you pretty much lose the use of that hand. Plus it can take a while to heal. There are much better places to draw blood from, yet we still see it all the time. And on top of that the characters are fine in the scenes after or in the case of shows like Supernatural and The 100, they are making fists and fighting with no problem.